द हार्ट ऑफ भारत, नागपुर, अ यूनिक ज्योग्राफिकल लोकेशन एंड रूल्ड बाय मेनी ग्रेट एम्पायर्स। Each of these empires had left their mark on Nagpur's culture, tradition and architecture, creating a fascinating blend of heritage. Friends, in the last two episodes, we had seen some Bhosle-era temples of Nagpur. Today, we will be visiting one more interesting site of the Bhosle era. We will be joined by Prachi Sharma, an architect and heritage enthusiast. Interested? Come travel through history with us. The Maharani Kashibai Temple or the Rajghat is located on the banks of the Nag River and is the royal crematorium of the Bhosles of Nagpur. As we entered this gate of the Rajghat, we saw many chhatris in the complex. As we walked in, we first came across the chhatri of Srimant Khandoji Chimna Bapu Maharaj. So what exactly are chhatris? Chhatri is a term used for a canopy-like structure. They are found throughout the northwestern region of Rajasthan as well as in Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. Chhatris are memorials that mark the location where aristocrats were cremated. A portion of the cremated ash was buried in the ground above which a chhatri was built in memory of the aristocrat. The origin of the chhatris can be traced back to the Rajput kings around the 16th century. Now, 18th century saw the rise of the Marathas, and when they came in contact with the Rajputs, they reinvented these chhatris, each Maratha clan adapting and adding their own designs to them. Just in front of this is the chhatri of Maharani Sati Kashibai. So who was Maharani Kashibai? She was the wife of Raghuji Raje II's son, Parsoji Maharaj. Now several Bhosle family queens had gone Sati here. Now, at the time of Parsoji Maharaj's death, the British government had just banned the practice of sati. Maharani Kashibai was very adamant to go sati. So finally, special permission was obtained from the then British government and the ban on sati was temporarily lifted for her. The ban was again imposed after she went sati. Therefore, Kashibai was the last sati in Nagpur.
Chhatri of Maharani Kashibai. Even today, this day of Dashera is celebrated here, and a lot of local people come here to pay their respects to Maharani Kashibai. As the local story runs, it is said that there was a British official who was blessed with a baby after he paid his respects to Maharani Kashibai. To pay his gratitude, he built a garden around this place, and it was started to call as the Kashibai complex.
From here, we can see the chhatri of her father-in-law, Raghuji Raje II. At the time he came to power, the Bhosle family had achieved great supremacy. The state had also become very prosperous. Indeed, the 28 years of his rule is known as the Golden Period. He was very religiously inclined and always strived for the well-being of his subjects. So he created not only marvelous temples, but also lakes, tanks, roadways, gardens, and palaces. In fact, he is fondly remembered as the architect of Nagpur. The Rajghat was built around 1744. At that time, this ghat had an area of around 18 acres. It was later encroached upon and now occupies 4 to 5 acres. There are 35 chhatris in the complex. Only the Samadhi of Mudhoji Raje II is not here because he died in Udaipur and his last rites were performed there. This is the Chhatri of the brave and ambitious Raghuji Raje I, the first ruler of the Nagpur Bhosle family.
We are sitting at the Chhatri of Raghuji Bhosle I. This place was chosen because this was the center of between the two palaces, the Bhosla Palace and the Sakardhara Palace of the old city of Nagpur.
Diplomatic as well as bold and strong-willed, young Raghuji Raje was a typical Maratha leader. Raghuji Raje I is perhaps one of the most underrated personalities in the archives of Maratha history. By the time he passed off in 1755, the Marathas had already added Katak under his banner. The Bhosles of Nagpur were one of the five ruling families that made up the Maratha Empire, and they have played an important part in shaping the history of Madhya Bharat. So while Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj established Hindavi Swarajya, Nagpurkar Bhosles, along with others, expanded it from Atak to Katak. However, we were distressed to see the sad state of this important heritage site. This place has a fusion of various architectural styles and is immersed in history. Each Chhatri here has a different story to tell. And should we not be preserving them for the future generations? It needs urgent attention like cleaning and maintenance. And each Chhatri should also have a small board with a brief information about the aristocrat. We just came to know that this group has organized a cleanliness drive at the Kashibai Ghat. Feeling hopeful, we came out. Friends, if you like this video, please like and share it. It will motivate us to make more such videos. With the promise to come back soon with another lesser known but fabulous heritage site, it's time to say goodbye. See you soon.